You're a woman. And she was a righteous woman. She was in the truth, and she still is righteous. And if any of you brothers want to wipe her up, you're getting a pure woman. Two, number one, have the experience of being a wife. She always been faithful. She never was a whore. So you're not getting a woman who's used with high mileage. She only been with one man. And she always been faithful to that man. The neighborhood people know about it. The people in the truth know about it. You can ask around and they will tell you that she's a righteous woman. She has three children, yes, but she's a righteous woman. You can definitely take her as a wife because even though she has children, she comes from the background of dealing with a brother who was righteous and she always been a faithful woman to him. So in that regard, that woman with three children, she qualifies to be a wife. Her speedometer is not high. She was not a hoe. She was not a thot. She always been pure and faithful. And even though she's no longer a virgin because she's with that one man, she still technically would be a pure woman. So a woman like that who have three children, two or one, you can marry her. But now, a woman who always been promiscuous as a teenager, always slept around as a teenager, had sex from when she was 12 years old, 13, she was given blowjobs, 14, she was getting her back banged out in school, in the bathroom, in the stair hall. Now she's 15, 16, 17, she's all over the place with men. This sister been having sex with different men multiple times. Do you really think that a woman in that position has any sort of audacity to even tell a man that she wants him to be her husband and she thinks she qualifies? No, she don't. She do not qualify because she's living a life of a whore. A woman who is taking dick by every man, dick on Monday, dick on Tuesday, dick on Wednesday, and now she's 25 years old. Have you ever calculated how many men been through that woman? You see, women don't technically tell men their sexual history. They'll say, well, you know, the last time I had sex was 5 months ago or 6 months ago. And they say that to make it seem like they've been celibate for a while. Listen, if you had sex 6 months ago, you a hoe still. You a hoe. Because you're not telling me nothing that's going to make me impressive. Like, that's not going to be impressive to me if you tell me you ain't have sex, you know, for like 6 months. I'm not impressed with that. Because that means you was a hoe 6 months ago. And you're only acting like you just now stopped. You understand? What's impressive to a man is when you walk into him and you're like, I'm a virgin. That's it. I'm a virgin. Because once you say I'm a virgin, everything that's going through his mind is wife material. Wife material. She's a virgin. But it doesn't stop there. Don't get me wrong, just because you're a virgin, it doesn't automatically make a man, or should make a man just say, okay, I'm gonna wife you up because you're a virgin. No. A man's supposed to understand that although you're a virgin, he has to understand your mental state. Now, just because a woman is a virgin does not mean she's mentally fit to be a wife. Some women need grooming, they need growing, they need to mature. This is where you brothers come in and teach these women. Because if their mother isn't teaching them, if their father isn't teaching them, they need you to groom them. You understand?
For example, if you get with a young lady
and you're trying to groom her and make her your wife, there's a lot of things in her that you don't want. She have attitudes, she got problems, she got issues. She's going to have a lot of crap that's going to be in her mind. You need to drive that stuff out as a man before you make that woman your wife. Because all of that junk will come out while she's your wife, and now you got to deal with all of this bullshit. You understand? So, the truth of the matter is, when it comes to a woman being a wife, the primary concern for any man should be, is she a virgin? You cannot make no woman your wife if she is not a virgin. And this is biblical. You understand? I've been teaching on this for so long. But brothers are still out here trying to make baby mamas their wives. I don't understand that. The minute I see a woman and she have children, the first thing I think of is all them baby fathers. And there's nothing in my mind or heart is thinking about this woman being my wife. Like, you know, you can say what you want, but it is what it is. At the end of the day, as a man, you cannot make a woman who is a baby mama your wife. She can only technically be your concubine. She cannot be your wife because she done lived her life. She done started a family. She lived a wicked life. She slept around with all different types of men. You don't have no idea how many men ran through a woman, and now you want to take her as your wife? Where is the honor in you? Where is the respect for you? Like, this woman been all over the place, but yet you think she's worthy to be called a wife. No, the only woman worthy to be called a wife is a virgin woman who never had no man to penetrate her. And when I say virgin, I mean virgin everywhere. I mean a woman who is a virgin everywhere. Because a lot of times you think a virgin is just a woman who had never had vaginal sex. No, a woman who never gave no man no blowjob, a woman who never been fucked in her ass, a woman who never been fucked in her pussy, a woman who never jerked off a man, a woman who never gave no man no hand jobs, no foot jobs, no nothing. This woman was never sexual with no man. You understand? She's pure. She comes to you like a gallon of milk that was never opened and the expiration date ain't no time soon. You want a woman who never been unwrapped. You want a woman who, when you pop the seal, it's fresh. You know, like when you buy something that says, do not use if it was open. See, these are warning signs when you buy products. It tells you, you know, if you find this soda bottle with the seal broke, do not drink that soda. But see, a lot of you brothers, you find a lot of women who their seal been broke. And yet, you want to make this woman your wife. You're crazy. You're out of your mind. You cannot make a woman who is not a virgin your wife. And see, any woman you meet who is not a virgin, and you're thinking about making this woman your wife, right? The thing that you have to consider in a situation like that, because, you know, there are exceptions for certain things. I would say that if a woman is not a virgin, she loses value, number one. She loses value in terms of being a wife. A woman who is a virgin can automatically hold the title wife. She can be honored like that. But a woman who is not a virgin, she lost her virginity, she probably slept with three guys, and she had no children. Could that woman be a wife? It all depends. It depends on how you feel about her. It depends on her spirit. It depends on if she willing to follow the Most High. It depends if she want to be in the truth. All of these things matter if you take that woman as a wife. Because technically, you're supposed to take her as a concubine. You understand? She wasn't a pure wife who got divorced, or not divorced, her husband died. I don't believe in that divorce shit. Let's make that clear. Let me say it again. I don't believe in that divorce shit. Because a lot of women will divorce a man and then talk about they going to get married. Brothers, be very careful with women like that. Women like that are dangerous. They're going to do the very same thing to you. Don't ever think that what a woman has with her previous man, that she's not going to do it to you as well. Everything she did in her previous relationships, she's going to do to you. Especially women that are pushing 30 and pushing 40. Women like that normally been through a lot of different relationships. So if they're constantly breaking up, constantly going through issues with men, it's not the men that are the problem. These women are too damn old to be going through this shit. A woman who is in her 30s should have already been married and settled down already. She should have been married. You understand? A woman who is 40 has no damn excuse. She's supposed to been married. She's supposed to be teaching other young sisters how to prepare to be married. But today's day, you got sisters that are 40 years old and they still talking about they waiting on the Lord to send them a man. I'm here to tell you, you ain't never getting no man. Nobody's marrying you. Real talk. You 40 years old, you a woman, and no man married you yet? You ain't getting married no time soon. And see, the problem with dealing with an older woman is that they come to the table with a lot of problems. They come to the table with a lot of mental issues. Even women that don't have no children. Normally, because they had sex with multiple men, their mindset is already done fucked up. I told you already, and I tell you again, the amount of men that sexually is intimate with a woman releases DNA in that woman. That woman will go through a metamorphosis. She will begin to change. She will begin to take on that brother's attitude, his mentality, his ways. She'll even start to mimic his looks. This is why when you normally see couples, they tend to look alike. So if a woman had sex with 30 men, that's 30 different brothers' spirits that went into that woman. And when a man releases DNA in you, that shit stays in you. That it stays in you, and it molds you, and it causes you to start thinking a certain way. And this is why a lot of sisters be acting funny. They have these mood swings. One minute they're good, next minute they switch up on you. Next minute they're very loving and passionate. Then they hate you and they want to tear your shit up. This is because they go through a lot of post-traumatic stress syndrome, and they have a lot of mental issues. A lot of them are schizophrenic. A lot of these women have bipolar issues, and it's a real, real problem. I'm not just here throwing around fancy words. This is real. You understand? So a woman who sleeps around with multiple men is technically not the kind of woman you want to be your wife. She will cause you a lot of problems because of her mental state. She will cause you a lot of issues. And see, this is why when I talk about polygyny and women be like, I'm not with that monogamy shit. I want a man all to myself. I'm the jealous type. I tell her, fuck you, get the fuck out of my house and go. Because I will find me another woman instantly. You understand? That's how fast this shit is. Like, I don't waste no time. One woman go, that makes room for another woman. I don't have no time to be worshiping no fucking woman. At the end of the day, I'm a grown ass man. I got a life to live. I got a plan for life. I'm a real dude. You understand what I'm saying? I'm not one of these simp ass niggas out here who are just out here ready to just waste your fucking time doing a bunch of bullshit. I'm a productive quality man. Any woman that got me in her life, she's blessed. Any woman who got me in her presence is blessed. And that's real talk, you know? So I don't really fret and go crazy over women who want to give a hard time about, oh, I'm not into that polygyny thing. I want you to be mine under monogamy. Bye. You're in no fucking position to negotiate with me. How many men you slept with?
Well, I'm not a virgin, but, you know, I still demand.
You don't have no reason to demand. That's like you selling me a car at full price and you ain't brand new. That don't make no sense. It don't make no sense that a woman slept with 15 different brothers. 15, mind you. 15 brothers been blowing this woman's back out. 15 brothers, he done sucked off.